Hey guys, today we are going to discuss about the velocity of the blood flow. Velocity of the blood flow is directly proportional to the volume of the blood flow, and it is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. Mean that the how much will be the volume of the blood flow as will be the increase or the velocity of the blood flow. The volume of the blood flow will be increases, the velocity or the speed of the blood flow will be also increases. And if the cross-sectional area will be increases, the velocity or the speed of the blood flow will be decreases. For example, there is a blood vessel nearly about having the cross-sectional area of the 2.5 centimeter square, and another one blood vessel which have the diameter of the 5 centimeter of the square, and there is 20 milliliter blood. This 20 milliliter of the blood have high velocity and the speed into the 2.5 centimeter square. Why? As compared to 5 centimeter of the square. The reason is this, because the cross-sectional area in the 5 centimeter square is increasing, the volume or the speed of the blood flow will be decreases. And here the area of the cross-sectional will be decreases, and the speed or the velocity of the blood flow will be increases. So another point, the velocity and the speed of the blood flow is highest in the aorta. Why? The cross-sectional and the blood flow from the left ventricle to the aorta is high, so that the velocity of the blood flow is highest in the aorta, and it has the highest chances to form the turbulent flow, and it also can damage to the blood vessel. How? We know from the left ventricle, blood enter into the aorta with the highest pressure, and also with the highest of the blood volume. Due to the highest of the blood volume and due to the highest of the pressure, the velocity is increases. When the velocity is increases in the aorta, this one is, for example, is the aorta, and due to the highest velocity, this flow change to the turbulent flow from the laminar flow. This flow will change from laminar flow to turbulent flow, and in this way, this blood cell will affect and damage and attack on the blood vessel. When they will attack on the blood vessel, they produce a pedicrant. And in this way, they have a high chances. Of hemorrhage. What is the cross-sectional area? Cross-sectional area, for example, this one is a tube. And this one is a cross-sectional area of the tube. As the cross-sectional area will be increases, the velocity will be and the speed will be decreases. As the cross-sectional area will be increases, the velocity will be decreases. For example, I put here the value. If I show you a graphical representation, here is the aorta. Aorta have on the y-axis there is a cross-sectional area, and the x-axis there is a blood vessels. In the aorta, the speed and the velocity of the blood in the aorta is high. How? We can see V is equal to QA. Q is equal to volume of the blood per time or per minute. In our body, the normal value of the blood is 5 liter. Is the volume, and time you can say second, and there's a cross-sectional area. If we take here the example of the aorta, 2.5 centimeter square, we will put the value of the 2.5 centimeter square of the aorta, and 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. So if we put the value of 1 liter into milliliter, it will be like that, 5000 milliliter per second, and this one is centimeter square, 2.5 centimeter square. And 1 milliliter is equal to 1 cm³. 1 milliliter is equal to 1 cm³. So we can put the value of the 1 cm³ in place of the 1 milliliter. If we put the value of 5000 cm³ second, 2.5 cm² and here will be value like that, 2000 cm². This one is the value. This one is the flow or the velocity of the blood in the aorta. So we can say that due to the low cross-sectional area, the velocity or the speed of the blood is highest in the aorta. And I said that the lowest velocity and the speed of the blood is in capillaries. How? Velocity and speed of the blood flow in the capillaries is lowest. How? From the left ventricle, this one is the aorta, and these arterioles will go into capillaries. This one is capillaries. This one. These venules, this vein, then this will enter into the heart. So like that. This one. And you can see that this all is the cross-sectional area of the capillaries. So this cross-sectional area is highest, more than the aorta, more than the artery, more than the arterioles, more than the venules, and more than the vein. So that's the reason that the speed of the blood flow is lowest in the capillaries. And the cross-sectional area in the capillaries is nearly about 3000 cm². If we put the value for normal our body blood is a 5 liter. 5 liter here and this one minute, and cross-sectional area is a 3000 cm², and 5 liter is converted into the milliliter, so 5 liter is equal to the 5000 milliliter, and this one is 3000 cm². Milliliter is equal to minute, and 1 milliliter is equal to 1 cm³, so we can put the value of the centimeter cube instead of the milliliter. If we put 5000 cm³ per minute instead and 3000 cm², this centimeter square will cut like that, this one, and this will be nearly about of the 1.6 cm³ per minute. Mean that this one is the flow or the velocity or the speed of the blood in the capillaries, and this one nearly about 2000 cm² per minute are the flow in the aorta. So that the highest velocity of the blood in the aorta and the lowest flow of the blood in the capillaries. And there's also a very important question, the highest resistance blood vessels name is arterioles. The highest resistance blood vessels name is arterioles. If I come here and a quick review that if the cross-sectional area is lower, then the speed or the velocity of the blood will be increases. For example, nearly about of the aorta have a 2.5 cm² of the cross-sectional area, and it has the 2000 cm² of the velocity. And if you come here into the capillaries have the highest cross-sectional area. Due to the cross-sectional area of the highest, the velocity and the speed into the capillaries are lowest. Why the lowest speed and the velocity in the capillaries? The reason is this, because there also the exchange of the gases and the nutrients. When there is the exchange of the gases of carbon dioxide to the oxygen and the nutrients, so it takes a time when it take a time, so there will be the speed and the velocity of the blood flow will be low. And the highest velocity of the blood flow in the aorta and the highest resistance blood vessels is known as the arterioles. That was all about the velocity of the blood flow.